Hello, my beautiful people. Welcome back to another video. If you have been around here for the last few years, you guys know that this is my favorite time of year. I love the days in between Christmas and New Year's, the first week of January. And you'll also know that I have filmed this style of video for the last few years, and it's definitely one of my favorite videos that I film. So welcome here. Today we are doing a prep, getting mentally ready for the New Year's. This is actually going to be video one of, I think, a 2 to 3 part series, at least 2 parts, but possibly a third as well. Today, we are definitely focusing more on the mental prep. So some vision boarding, goal setting. I'm gonna get nitty gritty into how I make my vision board, what goes into that, as well as goal setting and doing a bit of reflection from this past year. I think that so many people have this year rushed through the holiday season and have like made their vision boards so early. I'm someone that likes to slow down, enjoy the holiday season. So today is December 28th and I'm just slowly starting my New Year's prep now. So if you're finding this video before 2024, in the first week of January, in the second week, by the end of January, whenever you're finding this video, just know that you are right on time. There's no need to rush. If you feel like you're behind, like, you are totally okay. You're taking a step forward and wanting to work on yourself and set goals now, and that is what is so important. It doesn't matter if you do it a month before the new year or 2 months into the new year. You are so perfectly on your own time. But with that being said, let's just hop right into this video. I'm so excited and so happy that you guys are here and just ready to start the new year off on a great foot. The first thing that I'm actually going to do is take down all of this Christmas decor. And this is something that I normally do like off camera before I film this video, but I wanted to include it in this year's video because I always do a little space tidy, space reset, put away all of my holiday and Christmas decor before I start anything New Year's. I feel like it just brings clean, fresh energy into the space. And I always say that if my spaces are cluttered, I'm normally mentally cluttered as well, and vice versa. If I am mentally cluttered, my spaces are normally cluttered too. So I also like doing like a quick tidy up, little space refresh. If there's any new decor or anything that I got for Christmas, I normally set that up now as well. So that's what I'm gonna do first. I do also sometimes take 2 to 3 days before the New Year's to do like a full apartment deep clean, and that will probably be in part 2. So stay tuned. Let's clean up this Christmas decor. Oh, and if I haven't already said it, grab yourself a drink, get yourself a coffee, a kombucha, get your journal ready, grab a pen, a paper, and let's get ready to prep, goal set, and make 2024 your best year yet. I have to throw on a little jam playlist. Always gotta set the vibe, set the atmosphere, and get some good jams and tunes going, especially while you're cleaning. Just made myself a little cup of tea. This is just a green ginger lemongrass tea for the afternoon. I'm doing things in a little bit of a different order this year. So I'm gonna sit down and plan out some of my goals for the year now. Normally I would do my vision board first, do some reflection, and then some goal setting, but we're switching it up this year. I'm gonna do goal setting, vision boarding, and then reflection. That is the order that I'm doing it in this year. Usually I do whatever year it is, that's kind of how many goals I set. So 2024, I would normally do 24 goals, but that's starting to get to be quite a lot of goals. So I think I'm just gonna shorten it and do 20 goals. And for me, I like to set goals and intentions. Goals are typically more tangible, numerical value things, like things that you can actually physically see and check off. Like, for example, do 20 squats with 140 pounds or get 100,000 followers on whatever platform, or just numerical value goals. And then I also set intentions, which intentions are a little less tangible. They're more self-evaluated, personal reflection. So maybe you want to be kinder this year, or spend more time with friends and family, or maybe you want to work on your overall health. So there's something that is definitely more self-evaluated and less of a tangible thing, and just something that you can continuously and consciously work on and work towards. And one other thing that I'm focusing on this year is that making sure that my goals are reflected on me and do not rely on someone else. So what I mean by that is, for example, sometimes some goals that you set can be dependent on someone else's actions. For example, getting a promotion, things that are kind of like that are really dependent on, yes, your own actions and your own work, but also are really dependent on somebody else. So if you have a goal that is similar to that or just does rely on someone else, how can you rewrite it or rephrase it so that it is dependent on your work and your effort rather than somebody else's? But I'm gonna go ahead and write down my 20 goals for the year. My 20 goals. I'm gonna read out a few of them. Some of them are more personal, so I'm not going to read those ones out, but I definitely will share a few of them with you guys before we get into my favorite part of my New Year's reset, which is vision boarding. First three are all like social media growth related, so would love to hit 750k on YouTube. That was my goal for 2023, and it just did not happen, I think because I wasn't really focused on growth and just kind of being more consistent there as I went through a lot of like inner turmoil and just didn't have the best mental year. 150k on Instagram and then 200 on TikTok. So I feel like those are all pretty reasonable values and goals. My next one is post one podcast episode minimum per month. Pretty sure I did do that this year and it was pretty manageable, so I would love to be able to do that again this year. This is just my generic goal. I would love to be able to post more if I can, but I feel like that is reasonable and attainable for me. So that is that goal. I would love to travel to 2 new countries. This goal, I would love to be higher for more like 4 or 5 countries, but I just know that this year is not going to be a big travel year because Alan and I are saving for our wedding, so traveling is just not going to happen as much. Next is 250 pound hip thrust for 3x8. This is just a little gym goal for myself. I feel like I've been stuck at lifting the same weight for a while and I haven't been pushing myself, so definitely want to do that more this year. Also, more mental check-ins and brain dumps. Did not do enough of those this year. I also want to finish my first draft of the book that I'm writing. I feel like I really put that off this year and I want to get back into it. So 2024 is going to be my year to hunker down on that. And then I also want to read 20 books. I dropped this from 30 because I only read 9 books this year. And I have a feeling that 2024 is just going to be a really, really busy year. 30 books is just over 2 books a month. So 20 is just a little bit more attainable for me. And obviously always the goal is to overshoot the goals. But something that is attainable for me, I think, is 20. Like I said, I did 9 this year, so We'll see. Next one is one no phone day per month. This is definitely something different than a typical goal I would add in my yearly goals. And the main idea around this is just being more present. One of my goals last year was to just be present, and I feel like I did a good job with that. But now I'm gonna take it a step further and implement at least one absolutely no phone, no electronics, maybe like a TV, that might be my only exception, but like no phone, laptop, that sort of thing, one day a month. I also wanna take at least two online courses. Now that I'm done school, I wanna continue my education, whether it's doing like an SEO course or just something like that is learning, continuing education is definitely on my goals for this year. I also want to read my Bible at least 3 times per week. I was really good this year of doing my daily devotions and then implementing my Bible as well. So really just staying on top of that habit and implementing into my life further. I also want to overall eat cleaner. I feel like I have been really chillax with my diet and my eating habits for the last, I want to say, 2 to 3 years. And for me, I think 2024 is going to be my year to get in my best shape and just start eating cleaner again. I have not felt physically, mentally the greatest the last year, and I think it's just because I have not been on top of eating clean and just more regimented with my diet. I just want to feel more well, and eating cleaner is definitely, I think, a part of that for me. Want to have a more minimalist wardrobe. I have slowly been getting rid of stuff, but just want to continue doing that and like pat down my wardrobe, especially with just over a year left of living in this place by myself. I need to clear closet space for Alan, so we are making a more minimalist wardrobe. That is a goal for this year. I also want to run at least 15 kilometers. I was going to put run a half marathon, but considering that I've never even ran 10K, I think that that is a little bit overachieving if I think I'm going to run a half marathon in 1 year, which it might happen, but I want to get back into running, and 15K, but like a solid time for 15K is the goal. Alan and I also want to do a weekly Bible study together and just have like a dedicated time to catch up and chat, maybe talk about goals, and just like have a dedicated time that isn't just like us hanging out, but it is more personal and interpersonal. I also want to redefine my routines. I definitely, you guys know, 2023 was kind of a weird year for me, and I feel like I've been off my routine. I just don't have a routine that works for me right now. And so 2024 is going to be my year for finding what really works for my work schedule, for my morning routine, my night routine, just what makes me A, happiest, and B, helps me flourish the most. And then obviously I have a few other more personal goals, but that is a little recap of some of my goals for this year. I'm honestly expecting and working towards big things in 2024. A few things that I like to think about or add in when I'm goal setting are work slash career goals, health and fitness goals, life family oriented goals, and then financial and other goals. So those are kind of like the four categories that when I am writing down my goals, I tend to think about, of trying to place every single one of those goals in at least one of those categories and having at least a few goals from each so that my yearly goals are well-rounded. They're not like all health and wellness, or they're not all career focused, but I do like having a well-balanced goal list, I guess. But now it's time. I'm going to take you guys to my office. We are going to start vision boarding, my favorite part. All right, everyone, it is vision board time. Grab your iPad, grab your laptop, open up Pinterest. That is always where we start. For the last few years, I have shown you guys how I physically make my vision board, but not like the mental process that goes into making my vision board. I like to think of my vision board as a visual representation of my yearly goals, as something that is visually reminding me of those things that I set at the beginning of the year. I like setting my vision board as my laptop screensaver, as my phone screensaver, and just being able to have it always there to look at and remind me of the things that I want to accomplish this year. Similar to the goal setting process, I like having different components of my vision board. So health and wellness related, life and family and friends, relationships related, wellness, spirituality related, and then career and finance related. So kind of having the different major subgroups, I guess, of goals and life aspects throughout my vision board. So I like picking images that either directly represent a goal. So for example, maybe I'll put a picture of someone running to represent that I want to run 15K this year, or maybe I'll have someone lifting weights to represent that 250 hip thrust that I want to hit, or I'll have images that are just generic, like overall want to be healthier, overall want to go to the gym more, things that are inspiring as well and are more generic. So I have like a little mix of images that represent generic goals, and then I guess more filler photos that represent overarching aspirations and goals as well. And I like having a mix because then I feel like my vision board doesn't feel quite so overwhelming of that every single one of my goals is on there and represented, but rather it's an almost like a mood board of what I want the year to be and feel like the vibe for the year. So often the different years have slightly different color palettes. Whenever I sit down to do my vision board, I normally like to, a few days before I'm actually going to make it, make a board on Pinterest and start saving inspirational and mood board photos to like a 2024 board so that I can start having inspiration and start getting ideas of what I want to include on my vision board. So we're gonna go ahead, open up Pinterest, kind of go through a little scroll through what I already have saved, save some more pins, and then actually make my vision board. And I typically use PowerPoint to make it. I just copy and paste the image directly from Pinterest onto my PowerPoint, and then I like rearranging them, tilting them, angling them, different sizes, and just making it an overall mood board look really pretty and aesthetic. And another thing that I really like to include on my vision board are some quotes or just mottos for the year. So I typically like to find 3 to 4 to 5 different quotes or sayings to put on the mood board that I also want to have like encapsulate the year. I think I've covered everything that goes into kind of the mental process of making my vision board. I also try to not overthink it. If I'm scrolling through Pinterest and there's any photos that I'm like, yep, I want that on there, like sometimes there just isn't like a huge thought process to it either. You should have fun making your vision board. It shouldn't be a super like mentally tasking or challenging thing. Like, just put it together and have fun doing it. It should get you inspired and fired up for the new year. And that's what I love about making my vision board.
So for the last few years, I've put all of my vision boards under the same PowerPoint. So this is 2020s. 2021, 2022, and then this was last year, 2023. So you can kind of see they all have different themes and photos. I finished just in time because it's 4:30 and it's starting to get dark outside, but here is this year's, so I just have to export it and then I'm gonna set it as my desktop.
Now that my vision board is all done, I'm gonna do a quick electronic declutter. I typically would do an electronic and physical declutter, but I'm gonna do a more in-depth physical declutter another day. So right now I'm just going to clear my desktop, get rid of any files and things that I don't need on there. I like going into the new year with a fresh digital space as well, so open and delete any unread emails that I don't need, or just emails in general that I don't need, get rid of them, go through my spam, all that sort of thing. I'm gonna do really quickly now, and then we are going to do a little 2023 reflection and a journal session to end off today's prep for the new year. always forget how dark it gets at the end of December and in the beginning of January, just because it's so like snowy, cloudy, gray, foggy, gross, and it's literally 4:40 and it's already so dark out. But going to wrap up today's video doing some reflections. So I always like to take a good few hours and even like a few days to really sit and reflect on the past year. I think that so much goes on in a year that we forget all of the wins and things that happened. Like obviously big milestones you're not gonna forget, but sometimes just so much happens within a year that you don't realize it. So I like to sit down, A, journal, and B, just reflect on the past year and just really be grateful and thankful and go into the new year with that attitude and mindset. Some of the journal prompts and things that I like to do are, first off, 5 wins from the year. So 5 things, whether big or small, that I consider a win from this past year. I also like to write down 5 lessons learned. Maybe you can think about things that you would have considered failures or losses and think about key takeaways or lessons that you learned. What are some things that you're leaving in 2023? Things that you are bringing into 2024? What are you grateful for in this past year? Whether it's like a personality shift or something changed, just some things that you have been grateful for in 2023. What are some ways that you can improve for the next year? The list can go on and on, but those are just some of the main ones that I'm gonna be focusing on my journaling session for this evening and then also probably over the next few days. But I'm gonna start with the 5 wins and 5 lessons learned. But I'm gonna end off today's video here. I hope you guys enjoyed getting ready and prepping for the new year for 2024 with me doing my vision board. I hope you guys got some inspiration and are ready and fired up to set your own goals and do your own vision board. Again, all of this is just for inspiration as well. Don't feel that you need to make a vision board or you need to set a million bajillion goals. Really, prepping for the new year should be really internally focused and reflection based on how you can continue growing and learning and always becoming a better person. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for an amazing 2023. It was such a roller coaster, but thank you for being here with me and for spending it with me. I could not do any of that which I do without you guys, genuinely. You guys are the reason why I continue to be able to create content and just do this and share my life with you guys. So thank you so much. I'm so grateful for you all. I love you all so much. I'm so excited for 2024 to see what is in store, what God has planned for me, and just to make it an amazing year. But I love you all so much. Have a happy new year. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video. I love you guys so much. Bye.